Hi, this is Amy from the Altis store. I'm going to give you a quick demo of how to wire multiple solar panels in series. A quick refresher of why you would wire in series. If you need to increase the voltage of your solar array, you're going to wire them in series, plus from one to minus to the other. So for instance, if I'm trying to wire a system to charge a 24 volt battery bank, I would take two solar panels, I would wire the plus from one to the minus of the other, and then across the available wires, I would then have 24 volts. Same if I'm trying to charge a 48 volt battery bank, I would take four 12 volt panels or two 24 volt panels, wire them in series, and I'd get 48 volts. For a grid tight system, you're going to see a whole bunch of panels. Usually you'll see maybe 9 to 12 solar panels wired in series to get a very high voltage, and that would then go into the inverter to turn it into 120 volts or 240 volts for your house. So this is how you wire in series. Now, keep in mind when you wire in series, it increases the volts, but it does not increase the amps. So if I've got two panels that put out 5 amps each, if I wire them in series, I'm going to have 24 volts, 5 amps out. If I were to wire them in parallel, pluses together and minuses together, then I would have 12 volts, 10 amps. So we've done a couple of videos on different ways to wire in parallel. You can check them out here. And this is how to wire in series. So first thing I'm going to do is check out if they've already got wire coming off the solar panels that have solar connectors on them. I've got some older panels here that have got the non-locking MC connectors. So you can see they'll just plug into each other without needing any kind of tool to disconnect them. If you've got newer panels, probably newer than 2008, you'll have some sort of a locking connector. And they have little tabs on them that when you plug them in together, they're going to lock and you need a key to disconnect them. So find out what kind of connector you've got on your panels. Now, lots of different manufacturers make these locking connectors. So either check the connector to see if it's got the brand stamped on it. It might say MC or Tyco or Amphenol. Or check the data sheet for that particular solar panel model, because it might actually tell you exactly what type of connector it's got on it. So that's going to come into play in a moment. Now, what I'm going to be doing here is I'm going to take my two solar panels, and I've got my MC connectors on them. I'm going to take the plus from my first panel and the minus from my second panel, and I'm going to plug them together. So if I've got multiple panels, I'm just going to keep going on. I would take my plus from the second panel, plug it to the minus of the third panel, and so on and so on. So I'm going to end up with the minus from my first panel being free and the plus from my last panel being free. So that's when knowing what kind of connector you have comes into play. I'm going to get an extension cable that is going to be longer than the distance from the solar panels to wherever I'm transitioning into conduit. National Electric Code says if you leave the area of the solar panels, you need to be in conduit. So in this example, I'm going to be using a Midnight PV3 combiner box. You may be using a pass-through box or just some sort of an adapter to get into the conduit. So for this example, we'll be using a combiner box. Now I'm going to take my extension cable that's got the kind of connectors that I have on here. I'm going to cut it into two. Now note I didn't say cut it in half, because I'm going from my first panel in my string and from my last panel of my string. So that's not going to be the same distance. So you need to figure out the distances that you're going to be cutting these cables. It's easier to cut than stretch, so make sure you get it right. So I'm going to go into my combiner box. I'm going to open it up, take off the cover to make it easier to work on. And you see I've got my protective faceplate. I'm going to take that off as well. Now I've got a breaker in here. Depending on your system, you may have a fuse. Keep in mind that a fuse and a fuse holder, you do not want to turn it off if it's connected and there's sun on the panel. You don't want to turn off a fuse under load. A breaker is designed that you can, but you cannot do that to a fuse. So I've got my breaker turned off. If I had a fuse in here, I would have the fuse disconnected right now. I'm going to take my wire that I've cut and I've labeled with either paint or with outdoor rated electrical tape. white for negative, because this is a grounded system. A negative grounded system is going to be white, and red for my plus. I'm going to go in through a strain relief. This is a nice watertight connector that will let me get in there without letting water in. I'm going to take my plus and my minus. My plus is going to go into the bottom of the breaker or fuse. I'm going to tighten that up nice and tight. Give it a little tug just to make sure that it's in there good. I'm going to take my negative and go to my negative bus bar. Tighten that up nicely. Now I've already taken my ground that is connected to my racking. So I've got my ground wire going from the rack, and I've got my grounding mid clamps from Iron Ridge, and those are bonding the frame of the solar panels to the rack. I've got my ground coming from the rail going into the combiner box, going to my grounding bus bar. Now I've also got a lightning arrestor here. This is going to help prevent any damage from a nearby lightning strike. And so I've got my negative from my lightning arrestor going to my negative bus bar. I've got the ground going to my ground bus bar. And I've got my positive going to my positive bus bar. Now I'm going to be taking this finger bus bar and put it in the top of my breaker. So this is going to now give me a way to take my wire out of here in conduit and go off to wherever I'm going, my inverter, my breaker box, my charge controller, wherever I'm going. Now I'm also going to do that with my negative bus bar. I'm going to take a wire going out in conduit and from my grounding bus bar. So I've now got a protected series string going into the house. So I'm now going to take my positive wire, go to my positive connector. I'm going to take my negative, go to my negative. Now keep in mind, I still have this disconnected, so I don't have a complete circuit here. Now I'm going to then wire up the rest of my system back at the house, and then I'm going to be able to, after I make sure everything wired right, then I'll come and I'll turn on my fuse here, or my breaker. So this is a way to safely wire a series string of solar panels through a combiner box. I hope this was helpful to you. If it was, give us a thumbs up, give us a like and a share, and make sure you subscribe to our channels at Altis Store so that you can get notified of new videos when they're coming out. And also go to our website, altisstore.com, where we've been making renewable doable since 1999.